Hi guys, if you are starting to learn Divi, so I'm going to discuss the features that would be super helpful for you to design and to troubleshoot a Divi website, okay? The first one is after you install the Divi, okay, after you install the Divi website, you need to make sure that you put your credentials in the Divi theme options and updates and fill in everything in here. So you can receive an update from Divi every time there is a recent version, okay? So if you fill them, if you fill this out right, you should able to see this part, which is called update, move that one. Otherwise, this one will be disabled if you forgot to fill this in. So it's super important, okay? The second options that I really like is this support center. I think this was just recently released last year. I'm just not so sure, or 2 years ago, I think. So in these options, you'll see this system status is super important to make sure that you follow the best, the recommendation settings in Divi. So it says here, like in the upload file size, the site has only set it to 50 MB and Divi recommendation is 64 MB for the upload file size. So your goal, if you click in the full report, your goal is to make this everything green, okay? So PHP version, you can see this PHP version into your control panel. You can ask your hosting provider on this. This one as well is in your control panel. This ones, options, it can be configured in your control panel as well, or you can install a plugin called WP Limits, this one, and then you just enable this, okay? And I think you can, if you click this WP Limits, you just need to set your memory limit, add time, and upload file size, but this one is not complete. As you can see here, there's a lot of fields that needs to be configured, so I would recommend to put it on, to configure it in the hosting provider. But if you want to keep, if you want it to be quick, then WP Limits plugin will be great. Okay, now let's say you are having problem, like you cannot, you have loading issue in Divi. So the normal cause on that is probably the plugin. So you need to isolate the issue. So this safe mode will disable all of your plugins, and if you are if you are running a child theme, then this one will disable. So you don't need to go into the plugins area and then you click this disabled or enabled. So instead of doing that, you can just enable this safe mode, and this will deactivate all of your plugins temporarily. So these are, this is the basic for you to troubleshoot a certain problem. So let's say, for example, you have a loading issue, then if you disable, if you enable this one and the loading problem was fixed after enabling the safe mode, then probably the issue is the plugin. So after you enable the safe mode, you can probably disable all of the plugins and then activate them one by one, so you can identify which is causing the issue, okay? Now, this is for the troubleshooting. Again, this one is support center, is the troubleshooting area. And then in case you want to talk to an Elegant Theme support, there you just need to click this chat with support, and you need to log in to your personal Elegant Themes account, and make sure that this part is enabled, because if this is disabled, then the support cannot access your website, they cannot troubleshoot your website. So you need to at least enable this one to avoid back and forth conversation, because they will ask you to enable this one so they can log into your site and fix the issue. But if it's only basic troubleshoot, then having a remote access is not needed, okay? However, it's okay. And then the other one is this theme builder. So the theme builder is new in Elegant Themes. I like it so much. Before, when you want to customize your header, you need to configure the PHP file. And this theme builder makes it easier for us to design our themes. So let's say, for example, you want to have, so this is the website, okay? So for example, this is the website. And then you want to have a different header design into your website. So let's say you want to have a different design into your portfolio. You want to have a different header into your portfolio. Now, what you can do is just click the, I'm gonna delete this one. So what you can do is click this, add new template, and then what would be the where do you want the design to integrate? So let's say, for example, in the portfolio. So there is an option here, like archive pages or or presses or old portfolios. And if you want to be specific by category, then that can be also possible. So click that one. And then let's say, for example, you want to update the header section. So click the add custom header, build custom header, and then design. Okay. So you can build from scratch or choose a premium template. Click that one. And then let's say, for example, menu. And then you want to add, you want it to just remove the logo. You don't want to have a logo into your portfolio, then it's possible. And save. Then after you save that, you click this X in here and then saved. Okay. And now if we go to the portfolio, this is part of the portfolio, I think. Okay, this one, I think. So you'll notice that the banner was changed. The logo is no longer there because we updated, we created a custom header for our portfolio, okay? So I'm gonna remove that one. So that's really how it works for the Divi Builder. You can manage and manipulate your designs on Divi Builder, okay? There's also other options called Divi Library, okay? In the Divi Library, you can save styles. You can save existing styles, and you can also upload and export styles and integrate it on other website that has a Divi theme. So let's say, for example, we click this one, this page, and then we enable this builder, and then we want to save this design, okay? Click this. So we want to save this design. To save that design, just click the saved row, and then you name it. And then let's say, for example, test. And then you, if you want it to be global, when you say global, it will change dynamically. So you want it to be global, and then you add a category if you want. So if you click the save, it will go to your Divi theme library. Divi theme library, you'll see this one. So it is, you can save, and then you can just import a file. If you can import it back to a different page if you want. That's how it works. You also have other options, like normally Divi has a layout. They have free layouts, so you can just, let's say, for example, go to Elegant Themes Layouts. So construction layout Elegant Themes. Click this one. Okay, I think this one. So normally you can, they provide free in their blogs. They provide, I think this is already in the pre-made set, but they really provide free layouts that is not added in the pre-made set. So you can just import the .json file and then export it into the Divi layouts and then load it to your portfolio, okay? And yeah, you can also manage roles in here. So this one, I really like this. So let's say, for example, you have a new member that is an SEO manager only. So you can restrict some features and elegant themes. Like, you don't want this SEO manager to access your library. This one, you don't want to access the Divi library, so just disable that one. And there's still a lot of features in here. You don't want to access some kind of modules. So yeah, there's a lot of features in the role. This part, this area in Divi is very important for you to design and restrict some information into your website. Theme options to keep things, to make you updated, to make you in the loop every time there's new features in Divi. Theme builder would be for you to manipulate the design of individual pages, whether it is a portfolio or a contact us. Theme customizer, okay, let's talk about later. Role editor is you can manipulate the restriction of your members. Divi library, you can import templates from Divi, and you can also export, you can save your designs into the Divi library. Support center is for troubleshooting. And for the theme customizer, if you click that one and go to the general settings, you can change like the, you can change the buttons in here, like the you can see here, like it is changing. So you can manipulate the global design of the button, so in that part. And let's say, for example, in the home settings as well, if you want to, if you want the client page to be featured in the Hollywood into your home page, then you can do that as well. So just set it into the home page area, but we just want to keep it in, let's revert it back. So home and published. So yeah, for the theme customizer, it's more about tweaking the global modules or global designs into your Divi website. So that's it. I hope you've learned on this walkthrough process. Let me know if you have other questions about the basic features in Divi. Always play around into this area to give you a better understanding on how Divi works. Also in the theme options as well, if you want to add a custom CSS, then simply go in here. And if you want to add a jQuery then or an analytics code, then go to the theme options, integration, and in this part. That's it. Have a great day, guys.